Hello everyone, I am Dr. Yogesh. I welcome you to this new session in Genetics and Molecular Biology lecture series. Till now we have finished DNA replication, DNA repair, transcription and translation as well as post-translation modifications. Now we will switch on to protein folding and role of chaperones. So what is protein folding and what is the role of chaperone in protein folding and what are the disorders which may result due to misfolding of proteins, right? So first of all, what is protein folding? So after the proteins are translated, proteins are synthesized, okay, they will have a primary structure only, and most of the proteins, until and unless they get the quaternary structure, they are not functional and they will not subserve the function they are intended to. So the exit of a protein after synthesis from the endoplasmic reticulum may be a rate limiting step. If the proteins are not properly folded, they won't be released from the endoplasmic reticulum. The proper folding of protein is under the influence of chaperones. These are certain proteins which help or which have a role in the assembly and proper folding of the synthesized protein so that it has biological activity. It can subserve the function it is intended to. And the word chaperone literally means the older woman in charge of a young unmarried woman on certain social occasions. If the young unmarried woman are not properly dressed and not presentable, they won't be allowed in the social occasion. So, in the same way, if the proteins are not properly folded and they do not have a biological activity because of improper folding of the protein, they won't be released in the cytoplasm from the endoplasmic reticulum itself. Then, what are the? These are heat shock proteins. The chaperones belong to large family of proteins called as heat shock proteins, which are first identified in response to heat shock. So any stress may be related to radiation, heavy metals, free radicals or toxins, etc., would cause increased production of heat shock proteins and hence so called as stress proteins. And what is the mechanism of chaperones? The most chaperones exhibit ATPase activity. They bind ADP and ATP both, and this activity is important in the effect of folding of proteins. The ADP chaperone complex has a high affinity for the unfolded protein. So remember this, ADP chaperone protein complex has a high affinity for the unfolded protein, which when bound stimulates release of ADP with replacement of ATP. The complex in turn releases segments of the protein that have folded properly, and the cycle involving ADP and ATP binding is repeated until the properly folded protein is released. And the chaperones attach to nascent polypeptide chains and prevent wrong folding so that folding is allowed only in the correct direction, and they help in the assembly of tertiary and quaternary structure of proteins. So this is the mechanism of action of chaperones, and we'll see the properties of chaperones. They are present in wide range of species from bacteria to humans, and these are inducible by conditions that cause unfolding of newly synthesized protein. So maybe elevated temperature, exposure to various chemicals, they'll release the stress protein, and these are the conditions which will induce the unfolding of newly synthesized proteins. And they bind unfolded and aggregated proteins only. They show ATPase activity and bind ADP and ATP, which has important role in effective folding. These are found in various cellular compartments, cytosol, maybe in mitochondria and the lumen of endoplasmic reticulum, where before the proteins are released, they will ensure that the proteins are properly folded, which should have an intended biological activity. Coming to the examples of chaperones, there are few chaperones like BIP, that is immunoglobulin heavy chain binding protein. So these proteins are ensuring the immunoglobulin's proper folding. It is located in the lumen of endoplasmic reticulum. BIP binds to abnormally folded immunoglobulin heavy chains and prevent their release from the endoplasmic reticulum, in which they are degraded. Next is calnexin. It is located in the endoplasmic reticulum membrane, and it binds the monoglycosylated species of glycoproteins that occur during processing of glycoproteins. retaining them in the endoplasmic reticulum until the glycoprotein has folded properly. Then there is another one, that is PDI, that is protein disulfide isomerase. This is an enzyme chaperon which promotes rapid reshuffling of disulfide bonds until the correct folding is achieved. We know that disulfide bonds are required for protein folding. Reshuffle the disulfide bond, we can change the structure and folding of the protein. So this is what the mechanism of PDI is, protein disulfide isomerase, right? So it will reshuffle the disulfide bond and it will ensure the correct folding of the protein. Then there is another one, that is PPI, peptidyl prolyl cis trans isomerase, which have a role of chaperone, which accelerates folding of proline containing proteins only. So the proteins which contain proline will be folded by PPI, peptidyl prolyl cis trans isomerase. Coming to the clinical aspect of chaperone and its role. So if the chaperones are not functioning properly, those are called as chaperonopathies, and those disorders result from sick chaperones. These diseases progress with age. Initially, the manifestations of this disease may not be so severe to get detected, but as the age advances, their manifestation will be accelerated. The abnormal folding of proteins unassisted by chaperones may lead to Alzheimer's disease. So we'll discuss the Alzheimer's disease to understand the chaperonopathies and the manifestations of misfolded proteins. So coming to the Alzheimer's disease, this disease occurs in old age and it is the fourth leading cause of death among aged people after myocardial infarction, stroke and cancer. So you can now understand the gravity of the disease burden this protein misfolding disorders have on human population. So coming to the clinical features, the disease is characterized by slow progression of memory loss. So that's why initially we can say that a mild dementia is there, but it slowly progresses as the age advances, and it may manifest in the form of hallucinations also. There are personality changes, confusion and gross dementia. And finally, the patient enters into a vegetative state with no comprehension of outside world. Coming to pathological changes which occur in Alzheimer's disease, the disease is characterized by neurofibril tangles in CNS and formation of senile neuritic plaques and cerebral amyloid deposit. So neurofibril tangles and senile neuritic plaques along with cerebral amyloid deposits are the pathological hallmark of Alzheimer's disease. What are the biochemical alterations which occur in Alzheimer's disease? The neurofibrillary tangles are paired helical filaments which are made up of abnormal tau proteins. This tau protein, when those are normal, so normal tau is soluble and catabolized easily. And when the protein is not soluble, it will precipitate and will deposit, right? So the abnormal tau protein found in this condition, which is in the form of neurofibrillary tangles, is insoluble and cannot be degraded by tissue cathepsins and are deposited around neurons. So this deposition of abnormal tau proteins will result in neurofibrillary tangles. And what is the role of chaperone enzyme in Alzheimer's disease? So PIN-I is the recently found enzyme which is necessary for formation of normal tau protein. Normal tau protein are synthesized by PIN-I. This is the chaperone enzyme which is required for formation of normal tau protein. So absence of PIN-I in this condition will produce abnormal tau protein. And deposition of abnormal insoluble tau leads to loss of microtubules, thus damaging the communication channels in nerve fibers. And the synthesis of acetylcholine is reduced, leading to memory loss. So this is the role of chaperone enzyme, that is PIN-I, in synthesis of normal tau protein, absence of which results in abnormal tau proteins. And the neuritic plaques have been found to be due to deposition of an abnormal amyloid protein, that is beta APP amyloid precursor protein. And these neuritic plaques are derived from normal amyloid precursor protein. The mutation in APP gene leads to formation of beta APP from wrong cleavage of APP. So this beta APP is synthesized from APP, that is amyloid precursor protein, and This will deposit in the form of neuritic plaque if there is mutation in APP gene. Okay, so there is due to wrong cleavage of APP. Beta APP is precipitated around neurons as beta amyloid. This will also contribute to the manifestations of Alzheimer's disease. So we'll see what are the other protein misfolding disorders. There is Huntington disease, which is due to abnormally folded protein, that is Huntington. And in cystic fibrosis, we see there is mutation of CFTR gene, that is cystic fibrosis transmembrane conductance regulator gene. Okay, and there is Parkinson's disease, which is due to alpha synuclein protein, Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. So this is because of prion. These are infectious proteins. And Alzheimer's disease due to deposition of beta amyloid protein. These are the diseases which occur because of protein misfolding. And this was the role chaperone, the significance of protein folding and the disorders related to misfolding of proteins. Okay, this is the literature which is used. Refer this for further studies. Thank you so much for watching the video. Hope you have subscribed to the channel. If not, kindly do it. Please like and share the video. Thank you so much once again.